A town in Greece awoke to discover this eerie 980-foot phenomenon cloaking the coast. In a sleepy coastal town in the west of Greece, residents have awoken to a scene straight out of a horror movie. For almost 1,000 feet, a sinister veil has descended along the shore of the lagoon. But what's caused this bizarre phenomenon? Is it natural or something from another world? From the tip of the remotest mountain to the bottom of the deepest sea trench, planet Earth has many diverse and beautiful wonders up its sleeve. But although the landscapes of the world can often inspire wonder and awe, there are many corners of this planet where things get a little weird. But while we might expect the strange side of Mother Nature to rear its head at the bottom of the ocean or in the depths of the thickest forest, there are some places where it might catch us by surprise. For example, the picturesque town of Aitoliko in the Aetolia Acarnania region of Greece. With a town located on an island in the middle of two glass-like lagoons, Aitoliko is known by the locals as Little Venice. But unlike the famously spooky Italian town, this sun-drenched Greek island seems like the last place on Earth that something strange and eerie might take place. However, in September of 2018, pictures began emerging from the town that told a very different story. Apparently, residents of Aitoliko were being plagued by a singularly bizarre phenomenon. And the strange occurrence was the appearance of thousands of spider webs, scattered across the town like misplaced Halloween decorations. In fact, the web stretched for almost 1,000 feet across the trees and plants that line the lagoon shore. Moreover, they were creeping over moored boats, covering the vessels in a sinister layer of gray silk. And perhaps most terrifying of all were the inhabitants, an invasion of tiny spiders scuttling around their new dominion. For photographer Giannis Giannakopoulos, the strange occurrence represented a unique opportunity to capture the town in a whole new light. "It's natural for this area to have insects. No one is especially worried," he said in a September 2018 interview with CNN. "But I've never seen any spider webs this big in my life." "A strange and unprecedented spectacle I saw tonight at Aitoliko," Giannakopoulos wrote underneath a series of photographs of the webs on his Facebook page. "Nature has its own rules that, unfortunately, many times we wise people outguess, with the result that its consequences are painful," he warned ominously. But what happened to turn Aitoliko into such a spider's paradise almost overnight? According to Maria Chidzaki, a scientist who specializes in spiders, the blame lies with members of the Tetragnatha genus. This is a type of spider that typically reaches no longer than 0.7 inches in length. Even under normal conditions, apparently, Tetragnatha spiders can spin vast webs that are home to thousands of the minuscule creatures. But in 2018 in Aitoliko, the phenomena seemed to appear on a particularly large scale. And according to Fotis Pergantis, a Greek biologist and head of the nearby Messalonghi National Lagoon Park, the reason is simple. Apparently, Tetragnatha spiders love to eat gnats, and Aitoliko had no shortage of the flying insects during the summer of 2018. In fact, warmer than average temperatures have combined with the right humidity levels to create a fertile breeding ground for the critters, which are similar to mosquitoes. When these temperatures last long enough, we can see a second, third, and fourth generation of the gnats and end up with large amounts of their populations, Pergantis explained. And when the number of gnats zipping around Aitoliko increases, so too does the population of spiders that feeds on them. Elsewhere, experts pointed to an increase in the mosquito population as responsible for the boom in Tetragnatha spiders in Aitoliko. Obviously, this results from favorable conditions that made it possible to create this overpopulation, Chetzaki told the NewsIt website in September 2018. "The increase in the population of mosquitoes is certainly not irrelevant to this phenomenon," Chetzaki continued. Meanwhile, he pointed out that similar occurrences have been observed. "This is not the first time that it's happened," she explained. "It's a seasonal phenomena that occurs mainly at the end of summer and early autumn." In fact, Chetzaki pointed out that she had previously observed a giant web in 2003. This was in the Ilia region, some 100 miles south of Aitoliko. Moreover, she was quick to reassure both residents and visitors to the town that the webs were not dangerous, despite their somewhat spooky appearance. The spiders are taking advantage of these conditions and are having a kind of party, the scientists explained. They mate, reproduce, and provide a whole new generation. These spiders are not dangerous for humans and will not cause any damage to the area's flora. The spiders will have their party and will soon die. Apparently, Pergantus agrees. It's the simple prey-predator phenomenon, he explained. It's the ecosystem's natural reaction. And once the temperatures begin to drop and the gnat populations die out, these spider populations will decrease as well. So just how long can the residents of Idaleco expect to be living in a horror movie? At the moment, no one seems to be able to predict when the town's arachnid residents might vacate their premises. But until they do, Idaleco's human population is preparing itself for an influx of visitors keen to see the phenomenon for themselves. And how do those spider watchers know about it? Because Giannakopoulos's photographs went viral. Meanwhile, some observers have pointed out that this isn't the first time huge spider webs have made the news. In fact, back in 2011, a photograph captured in Pakistan showed trees encased in a vast network of the structures as millions of arachnids sought safety from extreme flooding. Similarly, in 2012, rising floodwaters caused thousands of giant wolf spiders to descend on Wagga Wagga in Australia. Indeed, entire properties were carpeted in their silvery webs. As in Pakistan and Greece, the effect was terrifying, although experts acknowledged that the creatures meant little harm to humans. Hopefully, the residents of Idaleco can take solace in this as they wait for their own arachnid visitors to move on.